E-therapeutics chairman Ali Mortazavi takes over as CEO, and he joins me now to talk about this new role. Hello to you, Ali.
Hello there. Thank you for having me.
Pleasure to have you with us today. So tell us why you decided to become the CEO then.
So I guess if I take a step back, in my previous guys, I worked at a company which I think was very technology heavy, is what I call it, in the drug development industry. So very similar to, you know, things that you hear about like CRISPR. I work in the field of RNA interference. And, you know, we had very many false starts, false dawns. Like a lot of our competitors, we spent a long time trying to optimize our platform and to really get a reproducible platform which basically worked and we were confident of going forward. You know, it took the best part of 8 years to do. And, you know, kind of, you know, story of traveling and arriving. Once that reproducibility was there, what I found was that as a company, and as an industry as a whole, we knew little or nothing in biology. We had no extra advantage in biology. A lot of our competitors were all going after the same diseases, very simple diseases, and the competition was very, very high, even though we'd made very, very big technical breakthroughs. So I guess, you know, my next guys, I started thinking about if I was going to start doing this again, I'd start from a biology perspective. We're trying to find an advantage from that perspective and then go to the kind of druggability issues of that. So to that end, I invested, I think, in e-therapeutics, maybe this time, actually last year. And I thought that the company has got a unique position in trying to understand biology and the complexities of biology, which suited exactly what I wanted to do. You know, probably one of the biggest hurdles to overcome for me was, you know, artificial intelligence, machine learning, big data, and drug discovery. A lot of hype around this industry. I had to be very satisfied that there was something tangible here. And I think when I reached that point, when I could see the tangibility, you know, then I decided to become the exec chair. And now here we are as CEO as well.
Some people, Ali, do find it difficult to understand what e-therapeutics does exactly. Can you maybe explain it to us?
Sure. Maybe the best thing is if I just take one slide from our corporate deck, just as a sort of point of reference. I won't go through it individually. So I guess, like, in essence, e-therapeutics is based on the concept of network biology. And here in this slide, you can see a very basic picture of a, what looks like a very complex mesh or a network with nodes. And in essence, network biology is based on the concept that any biological process, so let's take an example of hyperinflammation in COVID-19. So that's a very important biological process to understand. You can't assign that to a single molecule or protein within a cell. But in reality, within the cell, that biological process is operating in a network of molecules and proteins, which are all talking to each other. So if we take this example, there are many, many proteins all connected to each other by the lines that you can see. And this is a much more realistic of a kind of in silico model of hyperinflammation. And in reality, we're able to model any biological process in any disease. So this was the kind of central tenet of what we kind of do. We construct these networks, which are representative of any biological process. And I guess the core sort of expertise and skill set of the company lies in the very specific area of network biology and the long-standing kind of expertise we've got in it. You know, the kind of use of data sets and machine learning algorithms, and computational biologists, the hybrid computational biologists, cell biologists, and drug discovery people that we've got to come together and bring information and kind of wet lab outcomes together to sort of tangible outcome.
So talking about tangible outcomes then, how can a partner or you action these findings from information to outcomes?
Yeah, so as you say, information alone in this industry is not enough. We're not at the stage where a computer alone by any algorithm can give you an answer. So an important factor for me was that this company was able to kind of mix the informatics output with actual compounds which can be tested in, you know, traditional assays in the industry. So to that end, we have a database of something like 15 or more million small molecule compounds, which we use in conjunction with machine learning algorithms to find really the best compounds out of that 15 million to disrupt the network that I showed you, or any networks that we basically choose to want to model. You know, one of the many layers of difficulty in network biology is these networks are very, very robust, as actually all networks are, but biological networks in general. And so disrupting them, and by disrupting them, I mean, if that network that I showed you is a model of hyperinflammation, by disrupting it, we want to almost collapse it. Therefore, you reduce hyperinflammation. So combining these small molecule compounds in silico against the networks is another core skill set. But actually, in reality, at some stage, your kind of hands become dirty, and you rank the best, maybe the top 300 or so small molecule compounds that have disrupted the networks. We go and synthesize them, make them, and purchase them, and we use them in either assays of our partners or on our own to validate our in silico findings.
And tell us about your partnerships and potential future collaborations.
So at the moment we have good partnerships with the likes of Galapagos in the area of fibrosis, with Novo Nordisk in diabetes, and a top five pharma company in CNS space. So again, to show you the sort of diversity of disease area, again, the platform can take any biological process in any indication and be able to, very simplistic terms, model it in terms of networks, and then be able to sort of test those networks in wet lab settings. So I guess for me, the industry validation and the need for kind of biology as a whole, you know, I think is not just to novel therapeutics like the likes of CRISPR, but I think the pharmaceutical industry as a whole is looking for a differentiator in biology. And I think we can provide that for them. And that's been borne out in the collaborations that we've got running at the moment.
Is there anything else you wanted to add in today, Ali?
I think for me that maybe one of the things to focus on, I mean, there are many strands to this, but maybe an easy way to look at it is a very, very traditional pharmaceutical approach to testing compounds is they might do that in a blinded fashion. So they will take their own list of compounds, they will test it in assays and see if those compounds are generating what's called hits. A hit being that it's altering the assay, the phenotype, in a way they want. But they're doing that from a kind of blinded process. There's no biological or intelligent starting point. Very often they may generate hits, but to unravel back to the underlying biology is very difficult, if not impossible. Sometimes they never find out. Whereas our process, I think, starts from an intelligent process of saying, this is the biology we're interested in. We're putting it in a network context, which captures the complexity of it. Then we're going to the compounds. As an addition to small molecule compounds, we've added the RNAi component capability to the sort of druggability outcomes that we can expect. And, you know, we expect to be able to add these different drug modalities depending on what we find from the biology. So, you know, I think we're solving really a very big unmet need in the industry, which is that the complexity of biology, it needs to be captured somewhere. And I think that network biology is capturing that.
Ali Mortazavi, thank you very much indeed talking to us today as the new CEO of e-therapeutics.
Pleasure. Thank you.